Welcome to the subways of New York. If you're like me, the only experience you had with New York subways before coming to New York was the movies. And sometimes those depictions in the movies aren't that flattering. So it's easy to be a little bit scared of New York subways, but there's no reason to be. They're one of the easiest, cheapest, and safest ways to get around Manhattan. So hopefully, once you're done watching this video, you'll feel as comfortable as I do taking the subways of Manhattan. So the first thing you'll need is a subway map. They're available at most hotels. They're available in every subway station that has a collector or toll collector. And you can even mail away for one before your trip so that you have it in advance of you getting here. Look at the map, and the easiest thing to do is determine which route you need to take. We would locate the nearest stop to us, which in this case is this one. The easiest way to locate a subway stop is to look for the green balls right above the station. Subway stations aren't above ground for the most part. They're underneath the ground. So the balls are a good indication that you're in the right place. The next thing you want to look at is the sign on the station. In this case, we've got the Bleecker Street station. We're on Bleecker Street, and this is the subway stop for the number 6 train going uptown. That's the other thing you have to keep in mind. You have to know whether you're headed uptown or downtown. In New York, heading north is uptown. Heading south is downtown. If you wanted to go downtown, this would not be the right stop for you. You'd have to find the downtown stop. But that's easy. Once you locate one subway station, you'll know that the other corners of the street will have other subway stations for the same train going in the other direction. In this case, across the street, we have a subway entrance that's under construction right now, but normally would get you on the downtown train. We also have other entrances on the opposite sides of the street. So if you find an entrance for the right train, but going in the wrong direction, don't fear. Just look on the other corners of the street. In order to ride the subway, you're going to need a Metro card. You can purchase a Metro card at machines located in every station. You can pay with a credit card, or you can pay with cash. So bring one of those things with you in order to buy your Metro card. You can even check the balance of your Metro card on Metro card readers located in every station. There's also a map in every station, so you can double check that you're going on the right train in the right direction before you pay for your Metro card. When you pay for your Metro card, there are lots of options. You can go with an unlimited ride pass, which will allow you to use your Metro card in one day or over a certain time period like a week, as many times as you want. Those are obviously going to be a little bit more expensive, but if you plan on doing a lot of touristy things when you're in Manhattan, that's the way to go. It's $2.25 per ride otherwise, and you can buy them in bundles. If you choose to spend $10, they'll give you a bonus on your card. If you choose to spend $20, there's another bonus, or you can just put $2.25 on here and go through once. It's all up to you. When you're finished with the card, you can keep it as a souvenir, or you can choose to refill it the next time you're in Manhattan or a little later on in your trip. Once you buy your Metro card, you're going to swipe it into the Metro card reader located on the stalls at every station. The black stripe has to go down, and you simply slide your card through the reader. Machine will tell you whether it was able to read your card. If it wasn't able to read your card, it didn't charge you anything, but it will ask you to swipe at the same turnstile again. Don't move turnstiles or you may be billed twice. Just re-swipe at the same machine and you should be fine. It'll click, it'll read your card, and let you in. Did you like that hand gesture? Stations in Manhattan is the stations are not air conditioned and they can get very, very hot. The subway cars, however, are air conditioned and they're usually very, very chilly. So that's something to remember if you're coming to New York in the summer. When you're leaving a subway station, be sure to look at the sign above the exit that you choose to take. That'll tell you which corner you're ending up on. So in this case, we're going to end up on the southeast corner of Bleecker Street and Mulberry Street. That'll just let you get your bearings when you get upstairs, so you'll know that you're on the southeast corner, or whichever other corner the sign says.
I hope you've enjoyed our tour of New York subways.